Hello everyone. In this session, we will learn to install and configure SAP Business Object and BI Platform 4.2. As you know, BI Platform is a flexible and scalable solution for delivering information to end users in a multiple forms, including dashboard and interactive reports via any web application, over the intranet, extranet, internet, or any other corporate portal. As you can see at the given URL, you can access the trial version of SAP BOBI Edge Edition. Just go to the registration process, just quickly fill up the form. Once you have done with the registration, you will get an confirmation email. Along with the confirmation, you will also get the SAP product key. Without product key, we cannot process the installation. In the next phase, we are creating a virtual machine on Microsoft Azure platform. As you know, Microsoft offering 30-day trial period. Along with that, you will get around $200 balance. In that budget, we easily access around 16 GB Windows OS for 30 days, which would be sufficient to access the BOBI trial version. It's almost done. After creating the VM, just connect the VM with RDP. As you can see, we have successfully logged in and accessed the SAP BOBI portal, and here you can download the media. So I am installing on Microsoft Windows Server 2016. So download the part 1 and part 2. Once you're done with the download, just go to the download directory and double click on the part 1 and just install. You can see it's extracting the media. As I mentioned earlier that without the product key, we cannot process the installation. During the registration process, we get the product key. As you can see in the registration, I got the product key in my registered mailbox. Just copy and paste. Press next. Okay, select the language, the default is English. Just next. So here are a couple of installation option like the web tier. It's our initial run. So we will go with the full installation. press next. The default installation path is in C directory. If you want to change, you can enter, otherwise press the next. Okay, here we have to select the database option. We have two choices. Either we can install Sybase SQL anywhere on the same machine, or we can connect the existing database for our audit purpose. If we want to connect with the existing, we should have to maintain the particular driver for that database. Otherwise, we cannot connect to the database. So go back. And select the configure and install Sybase SQL anywhere. In the next screen, we can see we need to install Tomcat Java Web Application Server. Once you're done with the installation, just finish and go to the start menu and install directory. Here we have a couple of SAP application and services. The first we will explore the CCM is a central configuration manager, which is used to troubleshooting and node management. As we can see, the SIE agent is running under the CCM. If we want to stop or start any service, we can use this tool. the next is CMC, which is Central Management Console, that is being used to perform administration tasks like including user content and server management. Just use the password that we set during the installation. Right after login, we have the initial setup configuration. Just press the OK button. Okay, press don't show this wizard. Right after, we have a number of products that will be available in our BI platform. All the products will automatically started during the system startup. If you want to check any, you can do right here and just press the next. Here we have the folders. If you want to change any storage path, you can specify here. Otherwise, go to the default. Okay, apply. So we have done with the initial configuration. This was a brief session about the installation and configuration of SAP BOBI 4.2H edition. If you want to explore more about this product, go to help.sap.com. There you can find the administration, operation, and end user guidelines. For product availability, you can find the product availability matrix on help.sap.com. In the next session, we will explore the CMC in more details. We will perform some administration tasks. After that, we will view the BI launchpad, which is being used by the end users to access the view and scheduling and keep tracking of published business intelligence reports. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.